In two of my previous videos, I provided detailed descriptions of FLALS, an optical system that helps pilots maintain the correct glide path during aircraft carrier landings, as well as its predecessor, the mirror landing aid, which was invented and developed by the Brits in the 1950s. However, the first optical landing guidance system was created much earlier, in the early 1930s in Japan. The Japanese Imperial Navy had a slightly different approach to aircraft carrier landings than the American or British navies. Just as with takeoffs, the decision-making authority for landing was vested almost solely in the pilot. The Imperial Navy had no comparable officer to the US Navy's LSO, who used a variety of signals to assist pilots landing aboard aircraft carriers. No one on board Japanese carriers was charged with actively directing the planes. Flight operations were directed from a platform on the rear of the island bridge by an air operation officer called Hikocho. He was the ultimate authority regarding everything involving an aircraft, whether it was in the air or on a flight deck. He had, however, multiple flight deck officers, called Seibins, to assist him manage the air group. They didn't give the direct guidance to the landing plane, but they could signal wave-off using a red flag if it was judged to be a blatantly unsafe approach, or if the deck was fouled. To help pilots maintain the correct glide path, the Japanese came up with a simple yet effective system called Chakkan Shidōtō, landing guidance lights. Originally, it had been intended for night landing purposes, but it had proven so useful that it was used in the daytime as well. Developed in 1932 and trialed aboard Hosho aircraft carrier throughout 1933, it reached the fleet in 1934 and was installed on all Japanese carriers. This device consisted of a bank of two red lights set at the level of the flight deck, and a similar bank of four green lights set some 10 to 15 meters forward. Each of the 1 kilowatt lights was variable in intensity and equipped with a mirror so as to emit a very narrow cone of illumination. Matched arrays were located on the opposite side of the ship. The angle of the lights was adjusted for each type of airplane. Attack planes typically came in at around a 5-degree slope, fighters a half degree steeper than that. As the pilot descended, he attempted to make the lights line up so that the green lights were positioned immediately above the red. If the pilot could only see the red lights, he was below the correct slope. If the red lights were over the green, he was coming in so low that he would probably hit the ship's fantail. Likewise, if the green light was positioned far above the red, the pilot was coming in too high. Though the system was not stabilized to compensate for the movement of the ship in a heavy sea, it proved successful and was used throughout the entire war. That's it for today. If you like this type of presentation and would like to see more, please leave a like or comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.